This foe was called Mole Mysterio from the crowd. She wondered what name the crowd would give him if he returned to the arena again. This strange device was a blaster. All craft more deadly than most bows. She wondered what the smith would think. blasters make short work of most enemies. The king could get used to this. The fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. Victory in the arena felt good. Maybe Reggie could learn to like this. Had more wonders to show. This automobile could dig them a path anywhere and fast, even to the Crimson Fort, but it needed to be fed petrol, which the mole said Reggie could get in station 24/7, but it was not cheap nor easy. No change there then, the king thought. fighting pits, where the victors were legend and the vanquished were stains on the floor. These arenas were outlawed in his kingdom. When his mole friend said, not easy, he didn't think he'd meant possibly fatal. But it was the only way to get coin for petrol. It was the only way home. Another statue. They were so similar. They must be a set. Reggie had chosen well. Cheesecake was his kingdom's national dish, after all. Singing, the guard moles went to start celebrating, leaving Reggie to explore the old sector. The old sector had been left to its ruin and to grubs. Fresh cooking oil. Maybe now he could try the mole's fried crisp bugs. This was the fuel pump Jay spoke of, though it didn't seem to be working. Maybe, like the tram, it too needed electricity to work. Reggie didn't know what this creature was, but its teeth and claws were as sharp as they were fast. Reggie wondered what this feeling was. Fear? Or despair? Dead, and Reggie could barely believe he'd survived. He hoped this would be the last one he encountered. The pump was working. Time to get this fuel back to Jay for his automobile. With fresh oil, the mole was able to fry his crisp bugs again. He cooked a batch for Reggie. The king made a note to ask the chef to put these on his menu. The king was tired and bruised, but he had the precious petrol. This might be a place of wonder, but it had none of the warmth of home. Something was wrong. The Crimson Fort was locked down with guards at every door. The king had been away too long. The enemy had returned, just as he'd feared, but sooner than he'd have believed. They'd slithered in through a broken pipe in the crypts. His brother and the rat guard had driven them back, for now. His brother Dennis pointed the way. He'd meet them below at the broken pipe. Together, they would end the frog scourge for good. His new mole friend offered to stay and help Comrade Reggie with this fight. If the Rat Kingdom fell, Mole Town would surely follow. Died as he lived, defending Ratford from the scourge of frog kind. The guard captain had truly earned his place, alongside kings. In the king's absence, the builders had repaired the crypt entrance. Reggie was as glad of this sight as he was it had not cost him any gold. Dennis was waiting, just as he said he would, and called out to his brother. No doubt that was how they found him so fast. The frog scum. The toxic smoke was too thick to follow. But Reggie's mole friend told him there was hope. In Station 24-7, they sold a breathing device that would let him pass through the smoke unharmed. The king could go in Jay's automobile. Jay would stay and kill any frogs that came this way, or die trying. A strange, toxic world lay ahead. Reggie hoped he was prepared. The king was impressed by his brave mole friend. After the war, he hoped to know him and his strange people better. The Molberg's shield was thick and heavy, crafted from the strongest plate metal. Getting past it would not be easy. Slow targets. Slow targets make easy gold. The arena champion, Hulk Molgan, was a living legend of Moltown. His legend might have to live on without him. Champion, King Demolition. They cheered. One legend had died, but another had come to take its place. Thank you. The device made it hard to breathe, and a battle helm was more comfortable. But this protected him in a different way, from toxic smoke. With this, he would find his brother. Double trouble means double gold. Reggie cut the final combatant down. The crowd cheered his victory. Bloodthirsty though it was, he had grown fond.